Hello everyone, welcome to the current session of QTP training from qtpselenium.com. Look, whether it is QTP or you call it UFT, earlier it was known as QTP, now it is UFT, Unified Functional Testing Tool, right? The core concepts of the tool are same, right? So the first thing which we need to understand is why we use QTP or why we use UFT before we go forward and we see how to download and install it, right? Look, the thing is, obviously when you are testing an application manually and the application is stable enough that you have to you become literally bored testing it manually, right? You can use automation testing tools on it, right? That's why a testing tool like QTP is used. Okay, you know that your application which you are testing every week or every fortnight, okay, it is very stable and there are hardly any bugs in it, so you can simply write some automation scripts to actually and do the testing. Fine, that is why we use the automation testing tools. There are a lot of automation testing tools available in the market, like QTP is there, Selenium, Silk Test and all. Okay, now personally I feel QTP is one of the best tools, although it's paid, but yes, you get the value of money as well along with it, and that's why many companies use it, many big companies. Okay, so I think I made it clear when do we use QTP and why do we use QTP. We use it for the regression testing. All the automation testing tools are used during the regression testing phase when the application is stable. These days I have seen people using them in agile kind of testing and all. It is not recommended to use these tools over there because the application is not stable, but still if you want to use, you can. Okay, you might end up wasting some time. Okay, so now the first thing is downloading and installing the trial version of this tool. Okay, this tool, obviously it's a paid tool, you can download the trial version, install it, it is valid for 30 days. Fine, and in those 30 days you can access all the features of this tool. This tool works on Windows, and I think everybody has Windows 7 or Windows 8 these days, right? So the first thing is that to download it, you need to go to google.com and just type download QTP or download UFT, whatever you want. Okay, you'll get the you'll get a lot of links. Okay, go to the link from HP. Okay, because this tool is owned by HP, you need to download it from HP's website, or you write download UFT. Okay, you'll again get the HP link directly. Okay, the latest name of this tool is UFT, earlier it was known as QTP. So when you open this in new tab, okay, you will have this page coming up. Okay, over here you can actually click on this free trial download link. Hold on. Right, HP Unified Functional 12.02 software, this is the latest version. Okay, you can fill out this form and all, everything. In the end you will get a download link, you can download that. It's quite huge in size, right? It takes a lot of time to download it and all. Okay, so a download manager will be there which will help you to download it. You'll have to install the download manager. Okay, now once you have downloaded it, you'll get a folder like this after extracting the zip file. Okay, you'll get a folder like this, like I have it over here, UFT 12. Okay, you'll have a zip file which you'll have to extract. Fine, if you open this UFT folder, you will have a setup file which you'll have to execute. Fine, so hold on, let me run this setup. Okay, you'll get a lot of options, and you'll get unified functional testing setup. Okay, you click on that and the setup will start. You click on next, accept the terms and conditions, click on next, and you will see various add-ons coming up over here. Look, UFT or QTP can be used to test various type of applications like .NET, Java. You can test desktop based applications as well, you can test web based applications as well, right? So whatever plugins are there right now, these are various add-ons or plugins you can say, they are more than enough to test any web based applications, right? But if you have some flash application which needs to be tested, so you need to add the flash add-on, or if you have any web or any .NET application which has to be tested, so you need to add the .NET add-on. Okay, so these all add-ons will be installed on your PC. Right, it's not necessary that you need to install this add-on right away. You can install them later on as well. Once you have installed UFT, that is also possible. I'll tell you how to do that fine later on. So click on next and click on install. Okay, few of you might get a different window. It might ask you to install Visual C++ setup in the beginning, or you might get a window in which it asks you to restart your PC or something. Click on no over there. Don't restart your PC. Okay, if during the setup anytime it asks you to restart your PC, just don't restart it. I'll tell you when to restart it. Okay, so let it install. I'll just pause the recording for a while. Alright, so I have resumed the recording. Alright, so UFT has installed now on my PC. This is, you'll get the icon like this. If you don't get this icon, you can go in the start menu, you'll get the icon. Alright, now before you start UFT, there are few things which you need to know after you have installed it. Okay, first of all, you need to make sure, okay, I've not written it over here, you need to make sure that, yeah, I've written, you need to turn off UAC, user account control. Okay, and you have to make sure you have installed some add-ons and all. Right, so go to all programs and hold on, you'll have this when you type UFT, you'll get all these things. If you are not able to find UFT, you can also type over here and you'll see the exe file. Okay, right now if you go to all programs over here, you will find HP software option. Okay, if you go to this HP software option, inside it you will have UFT obviously. Okay, but inside tools you'll have lot of tools, and one is additional, you'll find something known as additional installation requirements. Click on that. Okay, don't start UFT directly. Okay, click on this, and you know, there are some additional configure Internet Explorer settings, configure DCOM settings from ALM. You uncheck all of them. Okay, probably just run one of them, which is configure Internet Explorer settings. Okay, just run this and configure the settings for IE. Okay, and close this. Do not run the license installation wizard. Okay, anything, if you do anything wrong, the license can expire and you'll not be able to use the tool again. You'll have to format your machine and you'll have to use it again. Okay, once you have done this, you have to turn off user account control in your machine, UAC. Alright, so UAC control can be turned off like this. You type UAC and you will get the user account control settings. You need to turn it off. You need to make sure that the level is at the bottommost, this leveler is at the bottommost section. Okay, and you will have to switch off your PC. You will have to restart your PC, sorry. Okay, after doing this, only then things will come into things will fall into the places. Right, now moving ahead, now this makes UFT ready. Okay, now if you start this UFT, you'll see a window like this coming up. Hold on, it will tell that the license will expire in so many days. Never click on install license icon. You'll never be able to start UFT again. Don't click on this. Okay, click on continue and click on OK. Right, let it open. Hold on. So this is UFT. It will open like this. Okay, now I'll come over to it. There are few things which I need to discuss. The first thing is QTP UFT versus other automation testing tools. Do you have other testing tools like Selenium is there and all? Selenium is one of the major tools which is used. Okay, now if you go by my opinion, initially there was no demand for Selenium. The demand was very less. Okay, but with time the demand has increased. Alright, with time the demand for Selenium has increased, and the demand for QTP obviously has gone down, but still there are companies which are using it. Okay, now it doesn't mean that it's not a good tool. Look, the thing is, it's the best tool if you have got the budget to buy the license. Okay, it's worth buying. It's with the automation is faster on this tool. The amount of time which you'll take to write script on QTP or UFT is much less than other tools. Alright, it is a foolproof tool, it works almost all the times. I've never seen this tool failing. Okay, right, on a tool like Selenium, if I talk about, there can be a script which you make today, tomorrow it might fail, you might face issues, but things like that never happen in UFT. Okay, so these are certain advantages of UFT as well. Okay, and it can also support desktop based applications which are not supported by Selenium. Okay, the disadvantage is that it doesn't work on multiple platforms like Mac. They say that it's compatible now. I'm not sure how much compatible is it, right? Directly you cannot work on Chrome and all in all those browsers, right? The most preferred browser in UFT is IE. Okay, now, and these are the few of the disadvantages of QTP or UFT, right? The easier thing is that it is easy to learn this tool. You need to learn VB scripting, okay, which is very, very easy. We'll be doing that in the training. Okay, now how much VB scripting is required? You need to have a good knowledge of VB scripting. We'll be doing in the training. Okay, simple record and run. Yes, so this feature is there in every automation tool. Every automation tool has this feature of simple record and run. Okay, what is that? You open UFT and you create a new test, a simple GUI test you can create. Alright, and then you can start recording and running. Hold on, just a minute, it's creating the test. Alright, so you just open the test and you'll find this icon. Okay, you'll find this icon to record. You click on this and there are few settings. Just keep the settings right now like this. Okay, and click on OK, and what will happen is that QTP or UFT will go in the recording mode. You open a new browser and say you go to the website, any website, say bbc.com, right, and you click on the link over here. So in UFT, some of you might see the code being generated like this is being generated over here. Okay, some of you might not see the code being generated. If you don't see the code being generated, don't worry. Okay, watch the next module. I'll tell you what are the various reasons when you might not be able to work with UFT. So whatever you record gets recorded in this script. Okay, and you can play it back. You can click on this play icon and run it. So this kind of feature is there in every automation tool. Okay, so if you're not able to record it or if you were not able to run it, don't worry. Okay, in the next module I'm going to discuss about that, right? So script got stuck on the second line. Yes, obviously it has to get stuck over here. Okay, I will not go into the intricacies, like, yeah, it's working now. Okay, so in the end you get a panel like this. This is a result panel. Okay, so now in this, the thing is, these are the results of running the test. Okay, this will tell you the summary, passed, failed tests and all, everything. If you don't want this window to come up every time, okay, most of you won't want that. Whenever you run this, this window comes up, right? You don't want it to come up every time. You can disable this window as well. Okay, I'll talk about everything. Fine, just be with me as we proceed with the course. You'll come to know. Fine. Okay, so you can go to this tools and options, and over here under run sessions, you can uncheck the option view results when run session ends, so the results will not come up. Okay, so there are a lot of other settings also which you need to do. So this was a simple record run scenario which I just covered. Okay, which another question which most of people ask me, that which application will we test? Will we be doing any live application testing? Yes, we'll be doing up the live testing as well, but please be with me. Okay, it's not something which you can do in one day. First you have to learn the basics, fundamentals, VB scripting, descriptive programming. Alright, so lot of other things, AOM, automation object model, lot of things are involved, and then we can start off with the end-to-end application. Alright, so now you can watch the second module.